Hi everybody, welcome back to another episode of Wolfenstein. Thank you for hitting that thumbnail and tuning in, it means a lot. Tuning in. Don't know why I said that. That's pretty dated. If you could find it in your heart, I'm just going to try and get this out of the way now, but if you could find it in your heart to sort of hit that like button, you know, leave a comment down below and hit that subscribe button to keep up to date, it would mean a lot. Thank you very much. Don't have to do it now, do it later, you can do it at the end of the video if you like, but it would mean a lot if you could do either one of those three things. If you do all three together, then you are a gem. Thank you. This video, I'm going to be posing a question, and this question will be... I did write it down, because I write them all down. Who is your favourite video game character, just in general? It's a bit of a broader sort of question, this one is. But who is your favourite video game character, and also put down the name of the video game in the comment section below. Thank you all, and let's get started, shall we? Now, I finished in the Dahat base. Secret cache, super technology. I don't quite know what I'm seeing.
So...
Okay, so... this leads to something, does it? Is there a clue as to what order these come in? Or do I just hit them randomly? Oh, I'm onto something here. And I cocked it up. Let's do it again. This better be worth it, whatever I get out of this. I swear, if it's like a gold-plated anything, I'm gonna be so pissed. Okay, it's that one. I'm assuming it might be this one. 50-50 chance. Ah, there we go. Last one. Ah. Ta-da! Ah, nice! So I got the full...
I think it'll fit in this here slot right here.
So I got like the full battery now, I think. Right. Let's get going.
Come in.
I read you, Caroline.
They have a lead on Sir's decryption keys for the nuclear cannon. Anya, it's a troop transport train recalled from the African front. On board is the chief research scientist for Death's Head's latest generation super soldat program. He's leaving for the Nazi lunar base tonight to oversee the launch of the new super soldat. The intercepts a troop transport train, locates a chief research scientist, steal his identity, and use it to permit Blaskovich to take his seat on the lunar shuttle. Once you're at the lunar base, you need to find the nuclear decryption keys and bring them back to Earth.
Hey, when you say intercept the high-speed Nazi troop transport train, how do we do that?
Best side will be the Gibraltar Bridge.
Geez, and how do we stop the train?
Set. Any ideas?
We can use this one. This is very, very powerful. Where, in English, you can call it... I mean, how's that? Spindly talk. You drop this in front of the train, this will stop anything.
Excellent. Leave right away. That third train is en route.
Wow.
You may want this for yourself, Captain Blaskowitz, but I'm planning on keeping it.
You give that to Caroline.
Nazis built this bridge 3 years ago. Straight shot to the African front. They're just
devouring Africa like they did everywhere else.
The train should be arriving at the bridge any moment now.
It's go time, Cap! Ready up!
Cap, I'll keep scouting for a place to drop you off close to the nautical railway wagon. I don't think I'll find one. Too much debris and ticked off Nazis. Keep doing your thing on foot.
William, in accordance with protocol, Beth's Het's chief research scientist will be wearing an all-white uniform. All right, let's go. Find the Nazi with the right uniform and steal his identification papers. That's your ticket to the lunar base. He will be in one of the train cars there.
Navigating in the direction of the spindly torque. It's roughly the same direction, and you can see that that thing from everywhere if you look up.
Inside, Death's Head's chief research scientist bound. Well, I'm coming for you. Nazi fucking spaceman.
Nazis all look like ants on an anthill, and you're like this sting poking. off, closer to the nautical wagon. Proceed down through the checkpoint.
I was a kid. The man I looked up to most was my wrestling coach, Coach Anderson. You remind me of him. All these years keeping the resistance going with Caroline, a lot of times I ask myself, what would Captain Blazkowicz do? What would Captain Blazkowicz do? Still do. All right, I'll drop you off here.
Straight ahead of you, dangling below the edge. All you gotta do is jump in. Papers. Now what?
We need to move fast. The Lunar shuttle leaves tonight from the Luna Nautica. You will need your equipment up there, but you'll need to check it as luggage. Not allowed in the passenger cabin. You need to keep a low profile. You may need a shave and a haircut. You certainly need some sleep. You'll need to recover your equipment from the luggage area once you've arrived at the lunar base. Finally, you need to find those nuclear decryption keys.
Alright, so I just realized now the mic was off. No idea how long it's been off for. I'll have to check in, you know, when I finish recording. Because it could have been off the entire video for all I know. I mean, I swear I've been putting it on and off, but it's a new headset, so I'm still getting used to it. The plane was a labor camp planned on the moon. Ah. Alright, so I'm on the moon. Dressed as a Nazi. Welcome to the moon. Welcome. Sort of like 60s space program. God, this William, like, you know, General Strauss does do the voiceovers for everything, doesn't he? Welcome to London Nautica. Welcome to the moon. He does those weird tracks that the prisoners in the Berlin prison, they listen to his voice on repeat. I'm paranoid now, I'm checking the mic every 5 minutes. But yeah, if that's going to happen to anyone, it's going to happen to me. Aren't you going to salute, boy? I don't know what I'm doing. Don't know where I'm going. Do I take one of these guys out?
Wissenschaftler hin? Wusstest du, dass der Chefwissenschaftler Weißmüller ersetzt wurde?
Fucking moon.
There's a mouse on this one. I will clean it out with soap. Now, Blaskovich, the goal here is to steal the nuclear decryption keys located in the command module. In order to reach the command module, you have to find a spacesuit and walk there on foot. Across the lunar surface.
Affirmative.
I believe in you, William.
Oh wow, took you through a lot. Ah oh, yeah, laser guns. He's coming closer. Huh. How do you not see me? Okay, this has turned into a very different game. I'm dead. Yeah. Ah, damn it. A damn dog. Yeah, there is a sort of like a drastic, I say, difficulty increase since that last mission. Which isn't, it's not like they're harder to kill or fight or whatever. It's very much to do with, I'd say, environmental design, like the way the levels laid out. Like in this, there's a lot of tight spaces, and those laser guns do a lot of damage. And in the bridge, it was more like just sort of chaos and debris everywhere. You weren't quite sure where you were getting shot from one minute to the next. Stupid dog. Stupid robotic dog. Ah. Alright, this chapter might actually take a while. Alright, those pistols do no damage. Okay. Attempt number 4. Or is it 5? I've lost count. It doesn't matter. Yeah, right, I may have to actually do my best to do stealth in this one. Okay, I'm gonna stay here. Hold my ground. Stab him, stab him, stab him! Hey. Wow, never thought I'd be this energetic about stabbing people. Alright, I think that's all of it. Now the question is, which direction do I go in? Alright, that door's open. Is that the way I came in, though? Yeah, I think this is the way I came in. Yeah, it's not even open. Okay. Yeah, there's an upgrade over there. Okay, let me check this. Find the spacesuit. Alright. I am completely lost. Find a spacesuit. Is there what? Is there just one lying around somewhere? Or? Is there any buttons I can get for like a prompt to appear? Anything? Oh, wow. No, actually no, there's work being done over here, so might be something. No. Not that I can see anyway. What about down here? This doesn't look good, does it? That doesn't look like something I should jump down. Eh. Hmm. Ah! These doors open. Oh my god. Alright. If that the last like 5 minutes of me wandering around, that didn't happen. They all just ran at me. Nice. And I survived. Yeah, I don't understand. If someone, if you see someone, like, you know, shoot a super soldier, or what you think is a super soldier, why would you continue fighting that person? If he's capable of taking down a super soldier, he's more than capable of taking you down. Especially if you're only armed with a sidearm. Crappy little pistol. I'm going to have to call an end to this video because I'm nearing the 50-minute mark. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time.